Mentally Unstable Wing of Ponyville Hospital by TwistedSkittles. Chapter 7. Give You Up. It had been a month. A month that felt like years. Years of beatings. Years of slop to eat. Years of mental torture. Pinkie was now convinced that she would never leave the mentally unstable. She had tried to escape a few times. Once even coming to the black door in front of the basement stairs. But every time she had been caught and punished. For escaping. For failing to escape. For being stupid. For having the idea. For even living in the first place. She now knew why Mind Twist had become so violent. She was fighting. Fighting back at the guards. Fighting the demons in her head. Pinkie Pie wasn't sure what kept the Black Pegasus going, whether it was for the taste of freedom or the thought of her parents welcoming her home. To Pinkie, it didn't matter anymore. She'd given up on everything. She'd given up on her friends rescuing her, on anyone for that matter. She gave up on Princess Celestia and whoever Dr. Hooves was. Derpy talked about him occasionally. Now she was covered with scars and bruises, like the rest of the insane of the wing. They would punish the patients most of the time for no reason, saying that if they can't fight things mentally, they should be able to do so physically. But the only ponies who Pinkie had seen fight back were Mind Twist and Luna. Mind Twist would somehow catch the end of the rope in her hoof, then would either whip the guard or tie him up. Then she would slam whoever it was into the metal walls violently so they helplessly screamed. The sounds could be heard throughout the wing. Princess Luna had stopped cowering when being tortured and had now begun wrestling the guard or nurse. When it was time for her medicine, the princess would throw the needle at the padded wall so that it would stick to it or make a rip. She would grab either the guard or the nurse and try to strangle them, usually before they are purple. More guards would rush in and try to separate them. Only once did they fail, and by then they were too late. Even Derpy had once broken one or two of her mirrors a few times, and she would reach out and kick them, often unsuccessfully due to her being tied to a chair with chains. Every day was the same schedule. Sleep for a few hours, then eat food, then go back into the room. Then you would get some exercise by running laps around the cafeteria. If you did not do a specific amount of laps, you were punished. Then another meal, back to your room for a few hours, then a small meal, then it was back to sleep. Occasionally, you would help someone to escape. Often it was Mind Twist, who would always somehow break out of her room. The amount of strength and determination she had received from the pill they had given her as a filly was frightening. But the unicorns of the staff would use their magic to replace the broken metal door instantly. They complained about this, saying a stronger door was never in the budget. Pinkie rolled her eyes at this. Often Pinkie would either sleep or just remember her life in Ponyville. There was nothing else to do, so you could only think or sleep. By now, Pinkie had bonded with the insane in the wing. At lunch, every pony, Luna and Mind Twist would occasionally join them, would sit at the same table, talking sadly about their old lives and how much they missed every pony. Poor Screwloose could only listen and bark, for the pony still thought she was a dog. Pinkie still had the same desire about her friend. She still wanted to hug the dog like Pony. But now Pinkie realized that Screwloose had some pony left in her. Occasionally, Pinkie would find her friend arguing with someone. It took Pinkie a while for her to realize Screwloose was arguing with herself. It seemed that Screwloose shared two minds, one of the dog and one of the other mare that must have been. And it seemed that it was the mare that Pinkie had fallen for. "She can't be cured," Pinkie would tell herself. "You only have the dog. Maybe one day she'll be mine. Even if I had kept her as a pet, at least she would have a family. I would take care of her, and she would be best friends with Gummy."